Hello, my name is Rui Campos, I'm from InescTech. In this short video, I'll present you the GROW project, which is being led by InescTech in partnership with IPMA. The research team involved in this project is shown here, and it's composed of around 20 researchers. The project is funded by COMPET 2020, Portugal 2020, European Structural Funds, and FCT. So let me start by the motivation for this project. The main motivation is the increasing use of autonomous underwater vehicles for performing underwater missions. And on the other hand, the huge amount of data that these devices are increasingly collecting while doing this type of missions, and sometimes in the order of gigabytes. But there is a big problem, because currently you don't have the communication means to upload this huge amount of data in real time, especially if you are not using an umbilical cable, which is the case for this type of autonomous underwater vehicles. So since there is no broadband communication means available, this data collected along the mission is only uploaded at the end of the mission. And this brings a huge problem to the table, which is a great delay in data processing and visualization, which can only be done at the end of the mission, precluding any adaptation or change in the mission along the course, which would be quite useful in several cases. So this is why researchers are looking to new solutions for enabling, at the end of the day, real-time data transmission to the cloud or to a central station. And this is exactly what we are trying to explore in the GROW project. So let me try to explain you the concept that we are exploring in this project. And it's summarized here in the text on the left. So it basically consists of combining short-range broadband communications with data milling to establish a virtual link between the surface and the survey AUV that is doing the mission underwater. So the figure also helps to understand how it works. So basically, underwater, you have three means for communicating. You can use acoustics that I already mentioned, which are very good for long range, but very poor for high data rates. So it only works for very low bit rates. On the other hand, you have optical, wireless, and radio, but these two suffer from range problems, so they only work for short ranges. What we are trying to do here in this project is to combine two things. On the one hand, short-range communications for enabling short-range data transfer between devices, and on the other hand, exploring the movement of a vehicle to move back and forth between the surface and the sea bottom to establish a kind of virtual link, virtual broadband data link, let's say, between the surface and the vehicle that is performing the mission. So let's suppose that we have this vehicle collecting some video data or bathymetric data. What would happen, according to this concept that we are proposing, is that we would send a vehicle from the surface, a submarine, that would act as a data mule. It would go dive into the ocean, go from the surface and meet the main vehicle, download the data that was already collected by that vehicle, and come back to the surface, upload this data to this vehicle. And in turn, this vehicle could transmit it to an onshore or on-land station, and the data mule could go again to collect more data, and this would repeat as along the mission of the main vehicle. Of course, we are not limited to a single data mule, and we can explore several data mules to make it faster and have reliability also in this virtual data link. So for further information about the project, you can visit the project's website, grow.inescTech.pt. You can listen to the Science Beats podcast that we recently released on the research challenges that we foresee for exploring the ocean. And you can also contact us directly You have here the email addresses of myself and Bruno Ferreira, my colleague that is co-responsible for the project. So thank you very much.